Learn more, achieve more.
Okay, now all of you listen. Today we are going to start with the very important and difficult topic, salt hydrolysis. Okay, so let us make it clear and let us make it easy so that you should be able to solve the questions very easily. Okay, salt hydrolysis. Before salt hydrolysis, it is not a new topic. It is previously studied topic, but the version of studying is different. What is different? Version of studying is different. Everybody knows that when an acid react with base, it will form salt and then water. It everybody knows it. Okay. So, but here we are going to study in the wrong direction. This direction, it is, if you go in this direction, this is called as neutralization. It is called as neutralization. Okay. So, but if you come in this direction, if you come in this direction, then only it is called as salt hydrolysis. Then it is called as salt hydrolysis. The basic difference between neutralization and salt hydrolysis is understood. It is just a reverse reaction of, it is just a reverse reaction of salt neutralization. Okay. So in the neutralization, what we will do? We will add acid and base, and what we will get? Salt and water. Here what we will do, we will react with the, we will react salt with water. Okay, so salt with water will give you acid and base. Okay, so that will give you the acid and base. Such reaction is called as salt hydrolysis. That means there can be two type of definition. There can be how many types of definition? Two types of definition. Okay. First on the basis of reaction. First is on the basis of reaction. Okay. So on the basis of reaction, what we will write? Salt hydrolysis is reverse reaction of neutralization. Okay. Another way of saying is with respect to salt. Salt when react with water forms acid and base. Salt when react with water, what it will form? Acid and base. Such reaction is called as salt hydrolysis. Okay. So two definitions. Again, I am repeating that there are. Okay. So acid plus base. In this, there are two definitions. First definition is reaction of water. Reaction of water with salt. Salt hydrolysis. Salt means already you know, when it react with water to form acid and base is called salt hydrolysis. That is first definition. Second definition is simplest definition that reverse reaction of neutralization is called salt hydrolysis. Okay, so up to definition part, I think everybody understood this. Okay. So apart from this only, the main basic, if you understand, then you will be understanding the numericals. Okay, because it is not nothing new. If you feel that it is very new topic and I am not aware of it, then that tension itself will create. It will stop you to solve the questions. So it is very important to start solving with the confidence. Okay, now that means for preparation of a salt, we require how many things? Acid and base. So based on this reaction from which it is manufactured, otherwise what we can say, what type of acid and base it is going to provide, based on that salts are divided into four types. Salts are divided into how many types? Four types. This is based upon the salt hydrolysis only. This classification is based on what? Salt hydrolysis. Okay, so different type of salts are made from different type of acid and base. Okay, from where they are made, from what they are made is based on that, what they have done, they have classified the salts into four types. Okay, I will be writing very short form, so you should be aware of the full form of that short form. Okay, first thing is salt of strong acid. Okay, weak base, SAWB. Salt of, first is salt of, okay, salt of SAWB, so strong acid and weak base. Okay, second one is salt of, second one is salt of WASB. So you can pronounce it as a salt of weak acid and strong base. Third one is salt of weak acid, weak base. Third one is clear, weak acid and weak base. And last one left over is salt of strong acid and strong base. Okay, so these are the four types of salt. This classification is based upon, this classification is based upon from what they are made up of. Okay, so salt can be made by using two types of combinations, because we have four two combinations with the acid, two combination with the base. Like suppose if I take HNO3, okay, it is a strong acid. If I take HCN, it is a weak acid. So then again, if I take NaOH, otherwise I will take KOH, okay, it is a strong base. And when it react with the NH4OH, it is a weak base. So by using four things in different combination, by using four things in different combination, we can make out four types of salts. Okay, so let us take the first salt of strong acid and weak base. For that, what I have to do, I have to select strong acid, okay, and weak base. That means this salt, if I want to make, I have to use the combination of these two. I have to use what? Combination of these two. Okay, salt of strong acid and weak base. Is it understood? Now, strong acid, always from the acid part, what we are going to take? We are going to take negative part of the acid. What we are going to take? Negative part of the acid, that is NO3. So from this, what I am doing? I am taking the NO3. Understood? From the base, we are taking the cation. What is the cation here? NH4 positive. That's why it will be NH4NO3. So salt of strong acid, weak base. This combination, I think now it is clear. NH4NO3 is a salt of strong acid and weak base. Okay. Now I will be asking you, so you can reply. You can reply through the chat option. Okay. Now by using this combination, what you can do, you can select one of the acid and base. So when I want to make a WASB, weak acid and strong base, you can reply it. Weak acid, what I have to do? I have to select HCN. From the acid, what I have to take? Negative ion. Okay. From the base, what I have to take? K. So that means KCN. KCN is an example of, okay, KCN is an example of what? Weak acid and strong base. Here the examples I am writing by making the combinations. Okay. So it is NH4NO3. Okay. Now here, what is the example? Weak acid and weak base. Weak acid and weak base. Both weak only I will select. Okay. Weak acid is HCN. Weak base is NH4OH. From this I will select CN. From this I will select NH4. So here the example become NH4CN. Very good. People started replying, like Somnath. Okay. He just went replied. So salt of strong acid and strong base. So this and this. From this K and from this NO3. So the answer will be KNO3. Okay. So now I think you got a clear idea about how to identify type of salt. Okay. So very simple thing is that we have to take the cation from the base, take the anion from the acid. Okay. So from that, let us take an example of CH3COONA. So from which which category it belongs to? This is acetic acid. Okay. This came from where? Cation of the acetic acid, which is a weak acid. And it is going to form NaOH. Okay. So it derived from NaOH, which is a strong base, and it is a weak acid, and that is acetic acid. Okay. So this is a weak acid and this is a strong base. So this salt will be WASB. WASB. Okay. This is how you will classify. Understood? Now, whichever is weak, they only will have. Whichever is weak, they only will have Ka. Whichever is weak, they only will have Kb. So in this one, what will be derived? Only Ka is available. Kb will not be there because base is strong. Okay. So once something is strong, there is no dissociation constant. There is no dissociation constant for it. Is it understood? So this is Ka and Kb. Okay. Now, if you are given with salt, how to identify out of them? I think it is clearly understood with the examples. Okay. And how to form a given type of salt also, if you are given different acid base, that combination also, I think everybody knows this. Okay. Now, let us know about the pH value. Okay. How to identify pH value. Okay. How to identify what? pH values. So let us take this NH4NO3. Here, acid is strong, base is weak. So the resultant nature is going to be acid only, because acid is dominating. So once the resultant is acidic, therefore pH must be less than 7. pH must be less than 7. I think you can imagine here. It is weak acid, strong base. Which is dominating here? Base is dominating. So base dominate means then what you have to do? You have to just make it as a base that is greater than 7. What you have to do? You have to make it as a greater than 7. Okay. Okay, greater than 7. Now, salt of weak acid and weak base. Okay. So, salt of weak acid and weak base. Now, we don't know the comparative thing. So, there are three options. It can be equal to 7. It can be greater than 7. It can be less than 7. That depends upon what? Comparative strength. Both are weak only. Among them also, there are chances. Chances that acid may be something greater than the strength of the base. Acid can be something greater than the strength of the base. That time, pH will be less than 7. If as base is something greater than the acid, then it will be greater than 7. Okay. pH will be greater than 7. If both are equally strong, okay. Both are equally strong, then only it is 7. Okay. So here we cannot confirm. We cannot say that it is always equal to 7, greater than 7 or less than 7. Okay. Now coming to the salt of strong acid and strong base. So if both are strong, obviously it is going to be 7. Okay. So there is no doubt. Here there is no chance. Always it is 7 because it does not even undergo hydrolysis. Okay. Like NaCl, pH blindly you can say you add any amount of water, it is going to be equal to 7 only. Okay. Now, if it is equal to 7, less than 7, greater than 7, then it will be depending on the comparative strength. If acid is stronger than the corresponding weaker base, less than 7. If base is stronger than the corresponding acid, greater than 7. If both are equally strong, then only it will be 7. And it is always greater than 7 because base is stronger. It is always less than 7 because it is always acid is strong. Okay. Now coming to the how to identify what type of hydrolysis. Okay. Type of hydrolysis. What I am writing here? Type of hydrolysis. Okay. So here acid base is weak. Base what and we have told you cation. Okay. So this will undergo cationic hydrolysis. What hydrolysis? Okay, again I am repeating. Here there are four types of salt and there are different types of hydrolysis. Okay. So salt of strong acid and weak base. Weak base. Here weak base. Base will provide cation. Acid will provide anion. Therefore, as an acid will provide cationic, base is weak, therefore cationic hydrolysis. Base is weak, therefore cationic hydrolysis. Here acid is weak, therefore anionic hydrolysis. Here both are weak, therefore both direction hydrolysis will be there, and there is nobody weak, therefore no hydrolysis at all. Okay, this salt, there is no hydrolysis, keep it in mind. Salt of cation and anion, salt of cation and anion will not undergo any type of hydrolysis, will not undergo any type of hydrolysis. Okay, whereas salt of strong acid, base weak cation, acid weak anion, both weak, both. Is it understood? Easy to memorize now. Okay, so I think you understood this concept now very easily. Okay, next topic we are going to study independently. Okay, independently. So first thing is we are going to start with the salt of strong acid and weak base. What we are going to start with? The salt of strong acid and weak base. Okay, so example of salt of strong acid and weak base is, sorry, weak acid and strong base. First we are taking weak acid and strong base, WASB. Okay, salt of weak acid and strong base. Okay, there are three things you should understand. First one is KH, second one is H, and third one is pH. These are the three things you should concentrate. Okay, KH, H and pH. Okay, so with the help of the KH, pH and H only you will be able to solve the numerical. Okay, KH is called as degree of, sorry, hydrolysis constant. KH is called as what? Hydrolysis constant. KH for this weak acid. So weak acid is there, only Ka will be available. Kw upon Ka. Okay, there is another formula for this, that is C into C alpha square upon 1 minus alpha. Okay, what is C here? C is the concentration of such salt. What is alpha here? Normally degree of dissociation. For this purpose, what we will replace it with? Degree of hydrolysis. Alpha is for dissociation, H for hydrolysis. Okay, now same way for H value. Same way for H value also there are formulas. Okay, so H value formula will be completely depending on what square this Kw. Okay, so Kw upon Ka into C. H is equal to what is the formula? Kw upon Ka into C. Okay, Kw upon Ka into C is called H value. Then pH value. Then what value? pH value. pH is equal to 7 plus half into pKa plus half into, otherwise I will write it here together, log C. Okay, so these are the four formulas you should remember. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four formulas you should remember for the weak acid and strong base. Weak acid and strong base. I think now you clearly understood. Okay, so everybody is able to see. Everybody is able to see or not? Now make a note of it. Okay, so this is weak acid and strong base. If you are perfect how it is derived, based on that what you can do. If I am taking here weak acid, therefore Ka I have written, purpose you should be clear. Then Ka here, and as a strong base, as a strong base pH should be greater than 7, that's why here 7 plus. Okay, 7 plus. Now I am changing here. Okay, now I will change accordingly. You should be able to make changes over here. Now weak acid, strong base. Now it will be strong acid, weak base. Salt of strong acid and weak base. So here Ka should be replaced what? Kb. Okay, and there is no such term over here. This formula remains same. And here Ka will be replaced by Kb. And here two changes. Here strong acid, so pH must be less than 7, that's why I will replace this plus with the minus, and pKa with the Kb plus log C will be same. Understood? plus is replaced with minus and KA. Sorry, here KB. KA replaced with KB. Understood? And log C. Any doubt about this? There should not be any doubt. Salt of strong acid and weak base. Okay. Next, coming to the third one. There is no formula for the fourth one. Why? It does not undergo hydrolysis. Okay. Weak acid and weak base. So here, both are there. That's why I will write KA into KB. What I will write? KA into KB. Understood? Now here, KB into KA. Here, this formula is very, very important. Okay. There is no concentration term. What is not there here? There is no concentration term over here. There is no concentration term over here. Because of that, what happens? PKA. Okay. PKA and PKB. So this will be PKA and PKB. Okay. Now, if there will be difference of minus PKA and plus PKB. Why? Because here this will be plus, you can write. Acid will reduce its pH and base will increase its pH. So PKB will be plus for plus and PKA will be minus. Is it understood? So there are total how many formulas? Four formulas in each and into three. That means 12 formulas you have to by heart. Okay. So if you are perfect, if the purpose is known to you, why it is plus here, why it is minus, then it will be easy to understand and it will be easy to memorize. Okay. So this is about the theory of the salt hydrolysis. Okay. So I will give a gist of it. First, salt hydrolysis, how many definitions we have done? Salt hydrolysis, we have done total two definitions. Okay. So first definition is in terms of the, first definition is what? In terms of the reaction, opposite reaction of the neutralization. Opposite reaction of neutralization is called salt hydrolysis, or addition of water to the salt is called as salt hydrolysis. Addition of water